Welcome to audio video system playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you parameters of video on television. And in that, I'll explain luminance of the signal. Then I'll cover contrast of the signal in video. Then I'll explain hue of the video in television. Then we will see saturation of the video in television. Then I'll explain ghost image, as well as we will cover viewing distance from the television. So all those things that I'll be discussing as a parameters of television in this session. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is, what is luminance of the signal. So first let us discuss brightness, or one can say luminance, of the picture in television. So it is intensity of light perceived by the eyes regardless of the color. So brightness explains intensity of light which we receive at our eye. It is not depending on color. It is just intensity of light. In black and white TV, you will be finding brightest part of the picture that is having higher in luminance or intensity, one can say, and darkest part that is having lower intensity. So in black and white picture, we can directly predict like luminance is high for brightest part and luminance is low for lowest part. But in color signal, we need to understand it is what intensity of light. So it is not depending on color. But still, based on color, even we can judge what could be the intensity. So for that, I'll explain you what is the basic relation of color and intensity. See, in monochrome TV, dark red color will appear as a black, yellow color that will appear as white, and light blue color that will appear as a gray. So in monochrome TV, if you insert video signal which is there with color TV, in that case monochrome TV, that will show dark spot with red color, yellow spot will be shown with white spot, and blue color that will be appear as gray shade. So this is what the case which will happen when you translate color into monochrome. In color TV, luminance signal that we need to understand based on RGB format, and in television tube even I have explained this luminance signal that we send for color TV along with R minus Y and B minus Y, where Y that is what luminance signal, and that basic relation of RGB with Y, that is 0.3 into R plus 0.59 into G plus 0.11 into B. So intensity, that is 0.3 into R plus 0.59 into G plus 0.11 into B. So this is what luminance signal in color TV. But practically, when you have color TV signal and when you change brightness, at that time you will be changing intensity of given picture. So if you increase intensity, you will be finding all colors are increasing, all colors are there with increased intensity, and if you decrease brightness, in that case you'll be finding all colors are having decreased brightness. So for that, let me give you one example of picture so it will be more clear. Now see, here in this picture, one room is clicked with three different photo. So for this part of room, you can see intensity of light is more as this picture looks brighter regardless of color. Right now we are just talking about intensity of light. So luminance, or one can say brightness, is more over this. With this portion, luminance is less compared to this, and with this portion, this picture is appear a bit darker. So intensity is highest over here and it is lowest over here, and in terms of percentage it is shown. You can see 100% intensity. If you say, then this is having 15% and this is having 14% intensity. And here in terms of luminance, it is written 1180 luminance intensity is there with this,
517 luminance intensity is there with this, and 195 luminance intensity is there with this picture. So intensity is shown by luminance, right? So intensity of light, that will be shown by luminance. One can see it over here. Now let us discuss few more parameters. Now I'll explain you contrast of the picture. See, it is a difference in intensity in between black and white part of picture. So contrast explains you the difference in intensity in between black and white part of the picture, above and over a brightness level, right? So here we need to see what is the difference in between intensity for black and white part of the picture for contrast. So during daylight, that variation in between maximum to minimum brightness, that will be very wide. It will be about 10,000 to 1. But in picture tube, we cannot produce that variation, but it will be around 100. We can have that production around 100 to 1. But our eyes, that cannot even accommodate more than that variation. That will be around 10 to 1. So see, this is how things are happening. Like in during daytime period, maximum to minimum brightness variation, that will be from 10,000 to 1. In picture tube, we cannot reproduce more than 100 to 1. And our eyes cannot detect more than 10 to 1. Right. So I'll show you that what is contrast by one picture, so it will be more clear. Now see, here two images are shown, right? And here this image, that is having higher contrast compared to this image. And how do we recognize this? So one can see the brightest part and the darkest part, that is having higher variation over here in this image. And that is lower in this. Like you can see the cloud, that is appearing a bit dark over here. And that is appearing white over here. You can see this mountain even. So that is having white part due to snow, right? But that is appearing bit dark over here, and that is appearing bit white over here. So intensity variation from maximum to minimum, that is been shown by contrast. So scale in between maxima to minima in intensity variation is been decided by contrast. If that scale is having higher gap from maximum to minimum, then contrast will be high. And if scale is having lower gap from maximum to minimum, in that case contrast will be low. So this is lower contrast image and this is higher contrast image. See, same image is there, but lower contrast and higher contrast, that is given to this. So one can understand what is that basic meaning which is there with contrast. Now let us see one more parameter, that is hue, or one can say tint. So this is a predominant spectral color of the received light. So hue, that is a predominant spectral color of the received light. And thus the color of any object is distinguished by its hue or tint. Like see, the green leaves have green hue, red tomatoes have red hue, and different hues results into different wavelengths or spectral radiation, and that is perceived as such by the sets of cone in our retina. So we can have hue of different colors based on its radiation of different spectral wavelength, right? Like green color is having green hue, red color is having red hue. So that is how things are happening. Like when you sit in atmosphere, like if you go somewhere in forest, green forest, right? So you'll be finding green hue is appearing. Why? The reason is everywhere green trees are there. So it seems like green hue is there. If you go somewhere in Himalaya, you'll be finding hue is whitest. Why? The reason is white snow is appearing on the mountain. So hue will be having white color there. So it shows you like what type of hue is there, right? Let us try to understand that by diagrams, it will be a bit more clear. Like see here, one room that you can see in four different photographs. So room is same, right? And even color of room is not different, but because of lighting which is done inside, different hue appears. Like see, in this photograph, hue is bit whitish, right? Here it is little orange, right? And see, shades are given with different colors by lighting. So this is how hue can be created. So hue is what? It is predominant spectral color, and that can be generated based on lighting that could be there originally with some pictures. So as it have discussed, like tomato is having red hue, green leaves is having green hue. So likewise, there could be predominant hue as well, as we can generate that by having lighting. Let us see saturation now. So what is saturation? This is a spectral purity of color light. So saturation shows you spectral purity. Hue is not pure color light, right? It is appeared color, while saturation is what? Spectral purity of color light. I'll explain you that so it will be a bit more clear. See, single hue rarely occur in a picture, so that indicates single color only. But when multiple colors are there in a picture, you need to have different colors in that particular picture. And to understand better quality of picture, we need to understand separate colors in a given picture. So for that, we need to see saturation. So saturation may be taken as an indication of how little the color is diluted by white. So if you have original color, right? Let us say you have an original color which is green. And in that, if you add white color, in that case, that will become light green. So light green, that may be a hue inside of picture. But if you remove that whitest color, in that case, you'll be having pure green color, and that pure green color, that is what? Saturation. So fully saturated color has no white. And as an example, one can have vivid green is fully saturated, and when you dilute that with white color, it becomes light green. So the hue and saturation of the color put together is known as chrominance. So hue and saturation both combinedly explains you what is the chrominance of the signal. Note that it does not contain brightness information. So hue and saturation does not indicate any brightness information. It is indicating chrominance information. So it is even referred as chroma. So hue and saturation both explains you chrominance information, where hue is not a pure color. It is a spectral shade which is happening, and saturation is what? Purity of color. And if you remove whitest part in the color, then you'll be having purity of that color. So let us try to understand that by one picture, so it will be a bit more clear. See, in this picture, this is the original picture, you can see, and this is saturated picture. Now in this original picture, you can observe this two person's face, and in that face, little white color that is added, right? But if you remove that white part of color from their faces and from their body, you'll be finding that is having saturated color, right? So here there is no white color which is there in this, on this faces. And even with the background, you can see this greenish color is there with this tree, as well as some other plants are there, right? But that green color, that is having little white shade. But if you remove that white color from that green shade, in that case you'll be finding it will be a bit more green. So ultimately, saturation color is having no white color inside, so that one can see it in this image. So this is how you can understand saturation. It is a pure color where you don't have any white shade which is there inside of that pure color. Now I'll explain you viewing distance of from the television. So see, viewing distance of the TV screen should not be too large, so that I cannot resolve details of the picture. So you should not watch TV from very large distance, so that you cannot observe that picture clearly. Even you should not watch TV from very closer distance, right? why the reason is, if you watch it from very closer distance, you will be finding pixels separately. The above conditions are met when vertical picture size substended at angle of 15 degree. So when you see television with substended angle by 15 degree, in that case above these two conditions will get matched. Like, one condition is you should not watch TV from very large distance to see proper details of picture, and you should not see television with very short distance where you'll be finding pixels are separated to each other. So these two conditions will get matched when you will be observing television from a distance where angle substended by 15 degree. The distance also depends on habit, also varies from person to person, and it lies in between 3 to 8 times of picture height, and most people prefers 5 times of height of television. So while viewing TV, a small light should be kept on it in a room to reduce contrast. So when you view TV, if you keep small light on inside a room, in that case you will be reducing contrast, right? And as I have explained you, in contrast, it is a variation in between maximum and minimum intensity of light, right? And that variation could be minimized as if you turn on light inside somewhere in the room where you see the TV. So that will not give you strain on your eyes, and there will be less fatigue. So now I'll explain you ghost interference. So see, ghost interference that happens because of discrete reflections of signal from surface, building, hills or towers. Like, see, as if you transmit signal from here, and here there is a receiver, and if signal is received from multiple paths, in that case there is a possibility of ghost interference. So it happens due to multipath fading, and you can see here a transmitter and the receiver is there. So this is direct wave and this is reflected wave. So this reflected wave that is receiving signal by multiple path, so there will be path length difference in between these two signal, and that will result into ghost interference. So you'll be observing, see, ghost image that is appearing like this. You can see over here there is a ghost image which is there in background of this image, right? So double objects will be viewed in case of ghost image. You can see it in this. So this is what about different parameters of television.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is, I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topics which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.